Daedalus Maze, the spinning labyrinth game. The game can be played by 2 up to 4 players. Each player picks 6 pawns of the same color. 4 of these pawns will be placed in the maze, and 2 of them will be kept in reserve, as they may be used later in the game. Pick the event cards and shuffle them thoroughly. Each player draws 5 event cards. Hold your event cards face down so that the other players can't see them. Place the rest of the event cards in the event pile next to the game board. Pick the Gods and Heroes cards and shuffle them. Each player draws 1 Gods and Heroes card. Keep in mind that these cards bear a number, which defines the power and the playing order sequence. The card with the smaller number is the most powerful, and the player with the biggest numbered card plays first, and so on. Place your Gods and Heroes card in front of you face up, so that the other players can see. Discard the remaining Gods and Heroes cards. Pick up the Beast cards and shuffle them. Stack them into the pile and place them next to the game board. They will be used later in the game. The crown represents the treasure and must be placed in the treasure chamber at the center of the maze. The player who starts first puts his first soldier into a field of his choice into the entrance zone. The rest of the players act accordingly. Take turns until 4 of your soldiers are placed into the entrance zone. Note that 2 soldiers cannot occupy the same field in the maze, even if they belong to the same player. Be sure to place your soldiers wisely. Once all the soldiers have been set, move the walls of the maze 1 step clockwise and the game is ready to begin. Each turn of the game is comprised by 4 steps. The first player may wish to use his cards. Then he moves his soldiers. The other players cast their cards and move their soldiers one by one, according to a game order sequence defined by their Gods and Heroes cards. When all the players have done their moves, the maze's walls are rotated 1 step clockwise. These steps are repeated continuously throughout the game. Cards are casted at the beginning of each player's turn. The player may choose to use his Gods and Heroes card and or play 1 event card from hand. The Gods and Heroes card gives you a specific ability which may be used in every turn throughout the game, but when the effect of the event card is accomplished, it has to be removed from the game. Take special notice that if a card has an immediate effect on an opponent's soldier that can be counteracted by a card that the opponent holds, then he may choose to use this card at the same time. For example, if the blue player uses a card that specifies death against the soldier of the yellow player, then the yellow player may use one of his cards to prevent this effect, even if he had or hadn't played already. If this card is an event card, then it must be discarded. The player may choose the number of soldiers he wishes to move in each turn. The movement can be either radial or peripheral, 1 field at a time. A diagonal move is also possible, but only as an effect of a card. The walls depicted by the red lines are the natural boundaries in the maze and cannot be ever passed, unless a card specifically allows doing so. As mentioned earlier, 2 soldiers cannot occupy the same position in the maze, even if they belong to the same player. This rule, however, does not apply for the treasure chamber, where more than 1 soldier can be placed. Take special care as you move around the maze. The walls of the maze are rotating and you may get trapped and lose your soldier, unless you can prevent his death with the use of a specific card. Also, your opponent's soldiers may try to block you, and if you can't move or prevent death with a card at your turn, you may lose your soldier. Object of the game is to enter the treasure chamber before other players, pick up the treasure and make it to the exit zone. However, the player whose soldier reaches first the treasure chamber triggers the Beast card. The first card is flipped from the Beast pile and the rest cards are discarded. The Beast card has an effect that may change the game scenario and lasts until the end of the game. It does not only affect the player that initially picked up the treasure, but all the players. The game is not just a race to the center of the maze and back though. There are many dangers in the maze. your opponents are now trying to block you, steal the treasure from you, and be the winners. Keep in mind that the effect of the Beast card will last until the end of the game, even if the treasure changes hands. Can you face the secret dangers of the maze? Can you claim the treasure, beat your opponents, evade the Beast, and make it back alive? Find out with Daedalus Maze, the spinning labyrinth game.